What if your next coworker wasn't just AI, but could actually think like a person, not just follow orders? We're talking about robots that process and learn like real human brains. And it's happening right now. Let's break it down. For decades, we've tried to make robots act more like humans. They can now walk, talk, and even smile on cue. But the next big leap? Giving them the ability to actually think like us. That means building machines that don't just follow orders, they learn from experience. Enter neuromorphic engineering. This area of research focuses on copying how our brains process information. It's all about creating AI that can learn, adapt, and respond in the moment. Instead of needing every step spelled out, these robots start figuring things out themselves. It's the difference between following a recipe and being a chef. And now, for the first time, it's starting to work. Scientists are creating neural systems for robots that process data like our brains do. They're designing circuits that mimic the way neurons fire and connect. And this allows robots to make decisions, learn from what they see, and improve over time, just like people. The result? A smarter, more flexible machine that keeps getting better the more it works. This is the kind of advancement that turns heads, and it's only the beginning. Traditional robots are limited. They operate using clear rules. If X happens, do Y. But these brain-inspired machines are different. They don't rely on a list of instructions. They learn from experience. That means they can handle new situations better. They find patterns, make predictions, and even understand things like tone of voice and body language. Instead of guessing what you mean, they start to understand it. Some can even navigate unfamiliar environments without any help. They don't need someone constantly telling them what to do. They can explore, adapt, and make choices on their own. This makes them ideal for complex or unpredictable jobs. From search and rescue to caregiving, the possibilities are huge. What's really game-changing is how these robots approach decision-making. They can weigh options, consider consequences, and act based on what seems most reasonable. They can even hesitate when unsure, just like a person might. That's not something we've seen in machines before. All this progress starts with hardware. At the heart of these thinking robots is the neuromorphic chip. These chips are built to mimic how the human brain sends and processes signals. Instead of using just ones and zeros, they use something called spikes. This approach is modeled after the way neurons in your brain communicate. The system is known as a spiking neural network, or SNN. It's efficient, powerful, and well-suited for learning on the fly. Major tech companies are racing to lead this new era. Intel has its Loihi chip, IBM is working on True North, and startups like BrainChip are bringing SNNs into real-world applications. These chips allow robots to process sensory data more naturally. That means they can feel things like touch or balance in real time. Combine that with advanced algorithms, and you get machines that really learn. Robots with these chips don't need constant updates. They get smarter as they go. And the more they interact with the world, the better they become. It's like a brain made from circuits instead of cells, and it works. With this kind of power comes a lot of responsibility. If a robot can think, does that mean it should have rights? What happens if it's mistreated, or if it makes a mistake? Should there be rules for how we interact with thinking machines? These aren't sci-fi questions anymore. They're real debates happening among ethicists, scientists, and lawmakers. Some argue that if a robot can suffer or understand, it deserves protection. Others think only humans should have rights. Then there's the legal side. If a robot messes up, who's responsible? The designer? The owner? The machine? These are tricky questions with no easy answers. But as this tech moves forward, we'll need to figure it out fast. We may even need to invent a new kind of law, one that applies to intelligent machines. Just like we have rights for companies, we might one day have rights for AI. So, who's leading the charge? All around the world, teams are working on this breakthrough tech. In Japan, engineers at Osaka University are making androids that respond to human emotions. They use brain-inspired models to read facial expressions and tone. In the US, DARPA is building robots that can make battlefield decisions on their own. They're using AI that reacts in milliseconds and adjusts in real time. In Europe, the Human Brain Project is mapping the brain's functions to guide AI research. China is building emotional AI that can respond with empathy in different situations. It's a global race, and everyone wants to be first. Universities, governments, and companies are pouring in resources, because whoever cracks this first will shape the future. This isn't just about high-tech labs. Brain-like robots could start showing up in your everyday life. Imagine a caregiver robot in a hospital that notices if someone's in pain, even if they don't say it. Or a tutor that changes how it teaches based on how well you're learning. These robots might one day assist in homes, schools, offices, and everywhere in between. They could do the tough, boring, or dangerous jobs, or help with mental health support by offering constant, non-judgmental help. They could remind you of tasks, help you solve problems, and even become companions. And because they learn, they get better the more time they spend with you. They'll know your preferences, your habits, your routines. These machines could become not just tools, but real partners. That changes how we live, how we work, and how we relate to technology. The impact will be everywhere. What do you think? Are robots with brains a good idea, or are we rushing into unknown territory? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and do not forget to watch this next video about Google Quantum Chip.